your own personal Jesus. Someone to hear your prayers, someone who cares.
My purpose for church is to meet people's needs.
I've always been for the underdog. I've always been for the outcast. I've always been for the persecuted.
Someone to hear your prayers, someone who's there.
A.A. Allen's my spiritual father. That was the man I loved. That was the man who
saw something.
You're all alone, flesh and bone, by the telephone. Lift up the receiver, I'll make you a believer.
He said, now Don, I want you to go out and I want you to start preaching on your own. It wasn't enough to just say, here's the gospel, here's the word of God, but you had to do something tangible. It needed to be done, you know. Somebody had to do it.
Reach out and touch faith.
And I have accusations from various groups on the internet. Fraud, embezzlement. You know, you'd have to be fraudulent. How could you live in a nice home like that unless you were stealing all the money? Only God knows the heart of people.
Personal Jesus. Someone to hear your prayers, someone to care.
Healing human hurts. You could see where somebody could really get to the midnight of their soul.
Feeling unknown and you're all alone.
I can see how that's possible. My faith wouldn't allow me to do that. Thank God. And if I could stop one person from crossing that line, it's worth everything to me.
Reach out and touch faith.
How can one give birth to a ministry or a cause without going through some kind of pain? Otherwise it would be, how can you know unless you walk in somebody else's shoes, so to speak? And is it worth it? You bet it's worth it.
Reach out and touch faith.